Every product has a price. We get that. But what happens when the cost to make a product goes up for something people are going to buy no matter what? So today, we're going to dive into a classic economic puzzle, one inspired by the lectures of Michael Raviv. And we're going to use the unique market for matzah to figure it out. The question sounds pretty simple, right? If it suddenly costs more to make matzah, who actually ends up paying for it? Well, the answer reveals a really powerful economic truth. Okay, so to solve this whole thing, we need to get our heads around one single crucial idea. It's a concept economists call perfectly inelastic demand. And trust me, it's the key that unlocks this entire puzzle. So what does that actually mean? Well, it means that you, the consumer, are going to buy the exact same amount of something, whether the price totally skyrockets or if it drops through the floor. Your need for that specific quantity is just completely fixed. And what's really cool is how this looks on a graph. You see, in our matzah market, let's say the demand is fixed at 100,000 packages a year. That means the demand curve isn't really a curve at all. It's just a perfectly straight vertical line. The quantity simply does not budge. All right, so we've got our fixed demand locked in. Now, let's throw a wrench in the works. Let's introduce a shock to the system, something that's going to shake up our neat little market. And here it is. The people who actually make the matzah are now getting paid more. So I have a question for you. Think about it for a second. Does this change affect the buyer's desire for matzah, you know, the demand, or does it affect the producer's ability to make it, the supply? Yep, you got it. This is all about supply. It's a supply-side issue. The buyers out there, they still want their 100,000 packages, no question. But for the producers, it's now more expensive to make each and every single one of those packages. So that hits the supply big time. So here's where it gets really interesting. How does this change in supply actually interact with our super weird vertical demand curve? Let's map it out on the graph and find the new market equilibrium. Okay, here's our starting point. We've got our vertical demand curve, D, sitting right at our quantity of 100,000, and then we have a normal upward sloping supply curve, we'll call it S0. Where they cross, that's our initial equilibrium. That gives us our starting price, P0, and our starting quantity, Q0. Simple enough. Now for the change. Because production got more expensive, producers just aren't willing to supply as much matzah at any given price. And what that does is it shoves the entire supply curve over to the left, from our original S0 to a new curve, S1. And boom, this is it. This shows us exactly what happens. The new supply curve, S1, now crosses our demand curve at a brand new point. So take a good look. What has changed? And maybe more importantly, what has stayed exactly the same? That graph right there, it gives us the answer to our puzzle, plain and simple. Let's break down exactly what happened. Just look at this. The new equilibrium price, P1, is way higher than the original price. But the quantity, it's still exactly Q0. The price went up, but the amount of matzah sold didn't change one bit. So what is the big takeaway here? It's a huge one. In a market where demand is perfectly inelastic, producers can pass on 100%, all of it, of their increased costs directly to you, the consumer. The buyers just have to take it, so they absorb the entire price hike. And that leaves us with a really big question, doesn't it? Because this isn't just about matzah. Think about other things where demand is nearly fixed. Things like life-saving medicine, or basic utilities like water. What does this tell us about who truly pays the price when costs go up? It's something to think about.